Good morning, students. Let us start a new topic today from chapter 3, Laws of Motion, and the topic is Universal Law of Gravitation, which is also called Newton's Law of Gravitation. Now, according to this law, every body in the universe attract each other with a force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. This is also a law given by Newton, so it is also called Newton's law of gravitation. Now, according to this law, every two bodies in the universe attract each other. No matter how small or how big the objects are, they will always attract each other with some force. Even if I take this chalk and a duster placed at some distance, there will be force of attraction between the chalk and the duster also. There is a force of attraction between moon and the earth also. There is attraction between me and you also. So every two bodies in the universe will have force of attraction, and this force of attraction between the two bodies will be directly proportional to the product of the masses of two bodies. If I take the two bodies as this, we can take it as small m, and this we can take it as capital M. Suppose these are two bodies. So these two bodies will attract each other with a force. Say the two bodies are placed at a distance of r from each other. This is the distance between the two bodies. So the force of attraction between these two bodies will be product of the two masses, or is directly proportional to product of the two masses, and will be inversely proportional to square of the distance between the two bodies. Square of the distance between the two bodies. Now let us try to give a mathematical expression of this force which is attracted between the two bodies using this relation. So it is clear from this statement that the force of attraction between the two bodies will be directly proportional to the product of the two masses and will be inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the two. So this can be combined and can be written as upon r square. Now, to remove this proportionality sign, we have to use a constant term, and here the constant term is G, capital G. This capital G is called gravitational constant into product of the masses upon r square. So this, using this relation, we can find the magnitude of the force that will be exerted against each other. And the value of G is equal to 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. this become because the unit of gravitational constant is Newton meter square per kg square. Let us see how this unit is come. If you get the value of g from this relation, it can be written as F into R square divided by product of the two masses. Now if you put the, or if you place the SI unit of each of these quantity, you will get force is Newton, R is the distance, so unit will be meter square, and since both are masses, so their SI unit will be kg, so kg into kg will be kg square. So you can finally get the unit Newton meter square per kg square. Now when you see g, the value of g, this is actually equal to the force. It is numerically equal to the force of the two bodies of mass 1 kg when placed at a distance of 1 meter. Suppose we have the two bodies with mass 1 kg each, and suppose the distance is 1 meter. When you put all this value here, let us see what we are getting. That means we are getting gravitational constant is equal to force. So we can say that gravitational constant is numerically equal to force for the two bodies which has mass of 1 kg and is placed at a distance of 1 meter. I hope the Newton's law of gravitation is clear to you. We can see some more examples next day to understand how are the forces exerted on the two bodies. Thank you. Good morning, students. We can continue with the same topic, that is universal law of gravitation in physics. Today we are going to see how to find out the force of attraction between the two bodies when it is placed at some distance. We have taken example of the force of attraction attracted or exerted between moon and earth. So we'll take the mass of moon, which is equal to 7.36 into 10 to the power 22 kg, and mass of earth is 5.96 into 10 to the power 24 kg. And the distance between the moon and the earth is 3.80 into 10 to the power 8 meter. So let us try to find out the force of attraction between these two bodies. We know F is equal to G M into M by R square. So where G is gravitational constant, if you place the value of G equal to 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 into M, capital M can be taken the mass of the earth, which is equal to 5.96 into 10 to the power 24 kg, multiplied by mass of moon, which is 7.36 into 10 to the power 22 kg, divided by the distance, square of the distance, which is 3.80 into 10 to the power 8 square. Now when it is cancelled and calculated, the force is coming equal to 2 into 10 to the power 20 Newton. So this is the amount of force that Earth exerts on Moon, and at the same time Moon also exerts the same amount of force on the Earth according to Newton's third law of motion. And it is because of this force of attraction that we find Moon revolving around the Earth. We'll take one more example of the force of attraction between two ordinary bodies. This was the example between two heavenly bodies, and now between two ordinary bodies, let the two bodies be of mass 1 kg. Ji, you also there? Now suppose the two body has the mass of 1 kg. Its gravitational constant is, and the distance between the two bodies suppose is 1 meter, so it becomes 1 square. That is, now the force of attraction will be equal to 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 Newton. Now you can see, for two ordinary bodies the magnitude of force is so less, and this is the reason why we don't find any kind of effect produced by this force of attraction between two ordinary bodies. We can see the effect on the moon or on the heavenly bodies due to the force of attraction, because this force of attraction is very large that causes moon to revolve around the earth. But with this less force of attraction, we cannot find any effect on the two bodies. We don't see the bodies revolving around any other body when the bodies are ordinary bodies or having the mass very less. So it is clear from this fact that this force of attraction is significant only for the heavenly bodies and not for the ordinary bodies, because the magnitude of force is very less. So we can collect four important informations from this universal law of gravitation. Number one, it is always attractive. Second, that force is directly proportional to product of the masses of two bodies. Third, it is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the two bodies. And number four is that it is significant only for the heavenly bodies and not for ordinary bodies. I hope it's clear to you. And our next topic will be acceleration due to gravity. Thank you.